America is just getting to know its new commander-in-chief. He is proposing a timeline that is about 3 months later than what he promised during the campaign, and he will leave behind up to 50,000 troops, a residual force or a support force, as he calls it.
Well, I'm very comfortable with the decision and strongly support the decision. And the president listened to all of us who were involved in this, General Odierno on the ground in Iraq, General Petraeus, who's responsible for the Central Command area, as well as all the Joint Chiefs, myself and Secretary Gates. And in that listening, we had a very thorough review, discussion, debate, it was the cumulative discussion that got us to the point where we made a recommendation for the 19-month withdrawal plan, and the president accepted that and has made that decision.
When the United States finally leaves Iraq, will it have achieved victory?
I think that we have, as I said, I think we have had a significant success on the military side. There is still the political side is still a work in progress in Iraq. And frankly, I think before you start using terms like won or lost or victory or defeat, those are the kinds of things that I think historians have to judge. But I think that from the standpoint of the military mission, we will have enjoyed significant success.
On January 19th, George W. Bush was your boss. On January 20th, Barack Obama is your boss. How are they different?
What the chairman of the Joint Chiefs and actually every member of the military does is serve the president, no matter who the president is.
Different stylistically, though? Different in how they carry themselves?
Well, I think individuals are always different. But, you know, I mean, I wouldn't characterize them one way or the other. What I'm, as I've seen President Obama since he's took over, he's listened to us. He's anxious to get the military's input to all his decisions. The discussions have been broad and deep, and I've been very comfortable both with the access and the ability to give that advice.
Are they different presidents? Do they have different styles, temperaments? What's the major difference?
Probably President Obama is somewhat more analytical, and he makes sure he hears from everybody in the room on an issue. And if they don't speak up, he calls on them.
A marked difference from his predecessor?
President Bush was interested in hearing different points of view, but didn't go out of his way to make sure everybody spoke if they hadn't spoken up before.
Did President Bush not want to listen to everybody?
Of course he did, and did listen to everyone. I think what Secretary Gates said was that President Bush listened to everyone, but if people didn't offer opinions, he didn't go and call on everyone in the room. Everybody has their own style. I'm not sure, you know, how much benefit you get from pressing someone who didn't want to volunteer something there. So, different styles, but the fact is, clearly, they're both listening to folks with different points of views and coming to their own conclusions.
Our goal, Bob, is to continue to reach out, and it's our desire that the Republicans would work with us in trying to be constructive rather than adopt the philosophy of somebody like Rush Limbaugh who's praying for failure.
You bring up Rush Limbaugh. Who do you think now speaks for the Republican Party?
You just named him. It was Rush Limbaugh. I mean, he has laid out his vision, in my view, and he said it clearly, and I compliment him for that. He's been very upfront, and I compliment him for that, because he's not hiding. He's asked for President Obama and called for President Obama to fail. That's his view, and that's what he's enunciated. And whenever a Republican criticizes him, they have to run back and apologize to him and say they were misunderstood. He is the voice and the intellectual force and energy behind the Republican Party, and he has been upfront about what he views and hasn't stepped back from that, which is he hopes for failure. He said it, and I compliment him for his honesty, but that's their philosophy that is enunciated by Rush Limbaugh, and I think that's the wrong philosophy for America.
We are a party with many ideas, and we have in that a commitment to make sure that we have positive alternatives if we don't agree with this administration.
The Rush Limbaugh approach of hoping the president fails is not the Eric Cantor House Republican approach?
George, absolutely not. And I don't think anyone wants anything to fail right now. We have such challenges. What we need to do is we need to put forth solutions to the problems that real families are facing today.